We all use this gadget known as the clock. But have you ever wondered how it works? In this video, I'm going to tell you about the technology behind the modern digital watch. And not only that, I'm going to show you a DIY digital watch that you can make at home using easily available 4000 series logic chips. The timekeeping element in every modern watch is a harmonic oscillator. A physical object that vibrates or oscillates at a particular frequency. This object can be a pendulum, a tuning fork, a quartz crystal, or the vibration of electrons in atoms as they emit microwaves. In all the watches nowadays, a quartz crystal of value 32,768 Hz is used. There are about 1.2 billion watches sold each year. The majority of them are inexpensive digital watches. Its dirt cheap price and better accuracy than the mechanical watches made them so popular and available to everyone who needs a timekeeping device. The reason behind using a 32.768 kHz crystal is very simple. We want an easy to use, low power, low price, high efficiency oscillating device. And 32.768 kHz crystal fills all the gaps, as its value is equal to 2 to the power 15, which makes it easy to use because we can incorporate very simple logic circuitry, that is a NOT gate and a Schmitt trigger for getting a nice 32.768 kHz square wave, which we can feed to a cascade of 15 flip-flops to get a very nice 1 Hz pulse. After getting a nice 1 Hz blip, all that remains is some sort of display mechanism, like an LCD screen. It is very low power because higher the frequency, higher the power. And we can run an RTC clock with 32.768 kHz crystal for 10 years on a single 3V CR2032 type cell. It is very cheap because of its very high demand in watch industries. And it is also very precise in comparison to a mechanical clock, which can lose 5 seconds a day, whereas a normal quartz watch loses 5 seconds in a month. I highly recommend watching this wonderful video by Steve Mold on how a quartz watch works. Check out the links in the description box below for further knowledge. Let's build the clock now, shall we? First of all, a huge thanks to Danyk. Because the design I used for making this digital clock is not my own. I used the circuit provided by Danyk. For building the clock, you need two 4000 series logic integrated circuits for the clock, the 4060 IC and the 4026 IC. A 4060 chip is a 14-stage ripple carry binary counter, divider and oscillator on a single chip, meaning this IC is equivalent to our AND gate, Schmitt trigger and a cascade of 14 flip-flops in a single package. The 4026 chip is a monolithic chip that contains a 5-stage Johnson's decade counter and an output decoder that converts the Johnson code into 7-segment decoded output. Let's talk about the circuit now. We are going to make our 1 Hz clock signal using a pair of 4060 and 4026 IC. Attach the 32 kHz crystal to the 4060 IC along with the resistors and capacitors, which makes the oscillation stable. You will get a nice 2 Hz clock signal at the pin 3 of our ripple counter IC. Feed the signal to our 4026 IC's pin 1 or clock input, but connect the reset pin of 4026 IC to segment G output. That way, it will count only for 0 and 1, because at 2, the segment G will be high and the chip will reset almost immediately, and we get a 1 Hz signal at pin 6, 9, 10 and 11 of our 4026 IC. This 1 Hz blip signal will then be used for the counter circuit, and we are using DRL or diode resistor logic, forming a 3-input AND gate for resetting the counter 3 and 5 at the value of 6 and counter 1 and 2 at the value of 24. This way, we can make a 24-hour clock using simple 4000 logic chips. Danyk has provided more details in his blog. Please do check it out. For setting the time, we tap the 32 kHz signal at pin 9 to set the hour and 256 Hz signal at pin 6 to set the minutes. If you connect everything correctly, you'll get yourself a digital clock. I hope you make this for yourself and share your experience not only with me but also with Danyk. I am probably saying his name wrong and I'm really sorry if I did. That's all for today. I hope you liked this video. Please don't forget to check the description box for more knowledge. And if you have any suggestions for my channel, please drop them in the comment section below. I will take a look. You can also share your project ideas for a future video. Until then, peace.